Hey you guys, welcome back. Now I'm going to show the overhead press. The key is to hold the kettlebell in like a cross position that goes down your palm. And when you're pressing up, you want to start from the chest level. As you're going up, rotate out before you're hitting your shoulders as well. And then your finger or your hand or your grip should always be pointed towards the sky. So if it's like this or like that or any other way, it's a sign of wrist weakness, and it does happen. So that's what I like about these kettlebells. There's a lot of wrist development involved, so I really do enjoy that. If you do a lot of typing or you're trying to stave off possibly carpal tunnel, this might work out. It all depends. I don't recommend going as heavy as I do though. So 45 is my light kettlebell, and then I think it's 45 kilograms is the heavy kettlebell. Like with this exercise, it's gonna be alternating between the two, and it's just a 1 minute rest between each light set and heavy set. And this is to optimize for time. So I started at 3, it's now 3:20, and I'm about more than halfway done with what I wanna get done. And with overhead rest, it's a little bit easier. You'll probably have to make further time arrangements for the Turkish getup, because that does take more time and more energy, and it takes more out of the individual. So I always acclimate an hour and a half for that. As usual, the core is the kettlebell swings, and then the additional stuff on top of that, one day at a time, rotating throughout the week. So with that being said, today with the overhead press, I'm gonna start out heavy, then light, then heavy, then light, then heavy, then light. And then that will get me through it pretty quick. Hands. See how I'm using my feet to spring up? It's a good way to do it with heavier weight. To let it down, just flip it over. And use your knees to let it come down to the ground, keeping your back straight. I tend to do it a different way. I swing it down, so that's a little bit different. You don't have to do that. That's just something I do. And it takes, when you swing it down, you're lowering your knees and your core to take all of your upper body out of it, and then you're just putting all the pressure on your quads at that point, which are big muscles. Thigh muscles are usually like biggest, and the feet are the most powerful muscles, so no sense in your upper body taking that type of stress. Okay, this is the lighter bell, so it's not that heavy to me, but I recommend like normal or average start out with 25, 35, 45, or 24, 35, and 44, 20 kilograms. For me, I've been doing it a long time, so I'm trying to be 45 pounds, 45 kilograms, and whatever the next weight is, 62.2, whatever that is in kilograms, I can't think of it off the top of my head, but that's where I'm starting this workout out, because I've been doing it a long time. All right, we can start on the heavy bell. We finished off this hand, so I always want to start on the hand I finished off of. Thank you. All right. Oh, sure to have a towel on hand because you will sweat doing these exercises. Okay, last set of five with the heavy bell. Let's get it done. Okay, a light bell. You don't have to clean up the bell. You can just pick it up like normal and then readjust it into your hand so it curves down like this. It's just something I do to keep up with it. Oh, 20 minutes, wow. That was the overhead press, alternating between light weights and heavy weights. Man, look at these two guys right here. That being said, I'll catch up with you guys in the additional videos for working the chest. So I've got three types of exercises for working the chest, all alternating presses. That's additional stuff. You don't have to do that. The core is always going to be the kettlebell swing and whatever other primary kettlebell lift you're doing that day. That being said, I'll catch up with you guys next video.